contact Los Angeles Center on 135.5. Good day.
Gemini 1962. Goodbye. Los Angeles Center, Gemini 1962 10,200 feet.
Gemini 1962, Los Angeles Center, altimeter 29.92, radar contact continue.
flight I set up.
Gemini 1 Niner 62, contact Oakland Center on 128.7. Good day.
128.7 Gemini 1 Niner 62. Goodbye. Oakland Center Gemini 1 Niner 62, flight level 265.
Gemini 1 Niner 62, Oakland Center, radar contact continue.
I can see the little shadow of our plane right here. See that little dot moving down there? That's our shadow. Right here. That's our shadow. Anyway, as I was saying, we left Los Angeles International Airport, and we're heading to San Francisco International Airport. So I just wanted to verbally give an input about that, in case anybody's wondering. So what I'm doing here is I watched a video on how to get an inside view of the airplane, and he showed me how to do it on the Airbus A320neo. That's standard, that comes standard in the Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. And what it is, I don't know if you have to put everything on hard like he did. He says put everything on hard and then go to your custom views or whatever the view, what is that called again? The showcase view. Go to showcase view, scroll down to fixed cameras, and then go all the way down to 13, and that's this view right here. Now, the first time I clicked 13, it went on the outside view of the tail. I don't know what's going on with my throat. So it gave me a tail view, but then I clicked on it again, and then it gave me this view. And then 12 is the other, this is the right side, right engine wing view.
Gemini 1 Niner 62, contact Oakland Center on 126.9.
Unfortunately, you get all of this. Boy, that guy sounds mean when he says
going to 126.9, Gemini 1 Niner 62.
You get a lot of the heat blur.
Oakland Center Gemini 1 Niner 62, flight
very
level 265.
And this too. I don't know what the heck all that is.
Gemini 1 Niner 62, Oakland Center, radar contact continue.
So that's how you get the view. You got to go to your settings, your options, and in your options set it for your flight model. I'm going to try this again without setting everything to hard, because right now everything's set to hard. The only thing that I did change is the pilot assistant. I turned on pilot assistant, so he's flying the plane, the co-pilot. I turned on these anti-stall, auto trim, radio comms, and piloting with cursor. I don't know what that means. Cursor. Piloting. Yeah, piloting and cursor. I don't know what that means if I turn it on, but it does. But I don't want to turn it off now because I turned it on since we took off from here. showcase. The showcase views, I've been through all of those as well. And right now we're just in the passenger seat relaxing, enjoying the flight, looking out at the scenery. The pilot, from what I last saw, was climbing. Let's go in the cockpit and see if he's done climbing, he's at cruising altitude now, or is he still climbing? Oh yeah, no, he's coming down now. He's coming down, it's 233. We're at 310 miles per hour. So, the ocean is to our left over there. That's the Pacific Ocean. We're in California. We left Southern California and we're going up to Mid-California, San Francisco. Yes, UI gun inside the cockpit, and it looks pretty smoggy and hazy out there. Look at all that haze. I didn't need to set any of those dials or anything because the autopilot or anything just knows it in his head.
Generic 656, contact Oakland Center on 128.7. Good day.
It's a nice view out this way. This one's actually a better view than the other side because you don't get all that heat blur dump on us here. You get a nice visual of the window, out the window, part of the engine there. It's too bad we couldn't switch seats or turn. I can't turn. I can't click on my right mouse button or the middle mouse button and it'll swing me around to look around the airplane inside. It doesn't allow me to do that.
Gemini 1-9-6-2, contact Oakland Center on 127.45. Good day.
Man, I'm telling you, the way he says that good day at the end. It's like he's
going
angry.
To 127.45 Gemini 1-9-6-2. Oakland Center Gemini 1-9-6-2, 17,700 feet.
Gemini 1-9-6-2, Oakland Center altimeter 29.92 radar contact continue.
I don't know if y'all got that, but the call sign of my aircraft that I put in the tail number is my initials, Keith Allen Silva, with the birth date of 62 for the year. So, and they put Gemini, whatever you want to say it. Because that's what the horoscope sign is. Anyway, what I could do is I could skip. But I could skip to the approach, but every time I've done that, it really messes everything up because it's like over speeding, runway's in sight, it's like chaos. But instead of having to sit here through the whole leg, reaching San Francisco, which I can't see. Basically, this is straight in. It's just showing a magenta line straight over to the airport. We're supposed to be landing on a certain runway.
Gemini 1962. Goodbye. NorCal approach Gemini 1962 11,500 feet.
Gemini 1962 NorCal approach altimeter 29.92 radar contact continue. Gemini 1962 contact NorCal approach on 127.15. Good day.
127.15, Gemini 1962. Goodbye. NorCal approach Gemini 1962 10,800 feet.
Niner 62 NorCal approach altimeter 29 decimal 92 radar contact continue.
Going to 133.95 Gemini 1962. NorCal approach Gemini 1962 8,800 feet.
Gemini 1962 NorCal approach altimeter 29.92 radar contact continue.
I see the San Francisco runway right here. It's the airport. Left right hand. So I'm hoping that the autopilot, the AI co-pilot will get us there to the runway, because generally you would come over the mountains, come wide out like this, wide, and then turn left in to the lake, turn into the lake like this and line up. But the way he's, it looks like he's going to go like straight in. Hoping this works. If not, well, we'll see what happens. This is my first time seeing if the AI co-pilot will land us or not. If not, I'll take over and see if I can get us down. So hang in there with us, and we're going to find out what's going to happen here together. By the way, the date today is February 22nd.
962 contact NorCal approach on 125.35. Good day.
Going to 125.35, Gemini 1962. NorCal approach Gemini 1962 6,700 feet.
Gemini 1962 NorCal approach altimeter 29.92 radar contact continue. 1-9-6-2 contact NorCal approach on 133.95. Good day.
133.95, Gemini 1-9-6-2. Goodbye. NorCal approach Gemini 1-9-6-2 5,200 feet.
Gemini 1-9-6-2 NorCal approach altimeter 2-9-9-2 radar contact continue.
NorCal approach Gemini 1-9-6-2. Request clearance to transition Bravo airspace.
Gemini 1-9-6-2 NorCal approach. Cleared through the Bravo airspace.
Cleared through Bravo airspace, Gemini 1-9-6-2.
Afterwards, this view to see us land.
1,000.
Because I have no gear. Oh, shit, I think I better take it. Because, look, there's no gear. Gear's not down here. But... set it, I think obviously you got to disconnect the AI when you're coming into the approach and take over the flight from there. I was hoping he would have done it all. Put flaps, gear, all that. But nope. Behind us. Going a little fast here. I just want to get around quickly so we can line up again and get back on track. Well, as you all witnessed for yourself, we all witnessed the AI co-pilot will not land the plane, at least for me right now, because I don't know if I can, I'm supposed to set it properly or not. I think so. I probably have to set things. But if there's no way to set it and make the AI co-pilot land it,
Gemini 1-9-6-2 Wincom caution, the Airbus A20 in landing runway 28 left. Clear to land runway 28 right.
Clear to land runway 28 right, Gemini 1-9-6-2.
A little more to the left.
turn, next taxiway. Airbus 759er contact ground on 121.8.
2,500.
121.8 Airbus 759er. Goodbye.
Overspeed. Overspeed.
Donner 18 Victor, follow the Airbus A20N on final. Windcom cleared to land runway 28 right.
Overspeed. 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 Overspeed.
Clear to land runway 28 right, Donner 18 Victor.
Overspeed. 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 Overspeed.
Air brakes.
1,000.
Gemini 1962.
I had
goodbye.
Landings.
San Francisco ground, Gemini 1962, request taxi to the gate.
Gemini 1962, taxi to gate Foxtrot 20 using taxiway Romeo Cross runway 28 left Romeo Zulu Bravo 1 Alpha.
Taxiing to gate Foxtrot 20 using taxiway Romeo Cross runway 28 left Romeo Zulu Bravo 1 Alpha Gemini 1962.
Okay, because that's a bit crazy. What I'm going to do is have the AI pilot do that. But it takes forever to get us there. This is where I'll let him take over this. Let him taxi us there because I don't have no markers.
Thank you.
passenger seat well up, and the co-pilot taxis us to our gate. So there it is. I had to land the plane badly. I hit hard, bounced a little. If I would have kept coming in straight the way I was, I would have been fine. I should have just dropped the power, let it glide down. But I, at the last minute, forced it down a little bit.
Bravo, Quebec 1, Alpha Bravo 5, Bravo Dauer 1-8, Victor.